Right now at 6, an 11-year-old girl injured in a hit-and-run is now spending her first night at home.
In September, Raegan Permetter was hit by a car and she was left for dead. Today, she talked to us about her recovery. KOCO's Michael Seiden is live and he tells us what doctors wanted her to do before she goes home.
Well, you know, walking up a flight of stairs is something that a lot of us take for granted, but for little Raegan, she had to use these steps to learn how to walk again, and it's an incredible accomplishment considering the little girl almost lost her life.
And how are you feeling?
Better than I was.
After spending nearly a month in the hospital, Raegan Permetter is finally going home.
How excited are you, though? I mean, your mom and dad are here, and you get to just walk out of here.
I'm really excited to go home.
Today, Raegan's family invited us to the Children's Center in Bethany. It's where the 11-year-old has spent the last 2 weeks learning how to walk and talk again.
And the first day she came, she was really quiet, just really subdued.
But now...
And she's a completely different kid. She's hilarious. She picks on me. She makes fun of me. She engages all of us in conversation, makes us laugh.
Despite her progress, the Shawnee Middle School student still has a lot of healing to do. The hit-and-run accident on September 26th left Raegan with a broken leg, multiple facial and skull fractures. She also has swelling on her brain. Doctors will now require her to wear a patch over her left eye because she has blurred vision. And to get around, Raegan will use a walker and a wheelchair. Still, her father is confident that she'll make a full recovery.
To see her smiling, it seems like she's back to herself. I mean, how does that make you feel?
Oh, it's great. It's great to see her smiling.
And you know, Raegan's family has wondered why the driver has not been charged. Well, today I called Pottawatomie County District Attorney Richard Smotherman, and what he told me is that the driver is a minor, so he's limited on what he can tell me, but he did say the police had completed their investigation, but now they're waiting for juvenile services to complete their investigation. Reporting live tonight in Bethany, Michael Seiden, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
All right, thanks, Michael. It is good to see her up and moving around. Raegan is expected to head back to school in early 2013.